Yeah.
Okay, good evening.
Good evening.
Yeah. Well, today, quite a lot of people.
Because of you.
A lot of money. A lot of money. All will be more interested in money.
Pay money.
Huh?
A lot of people, they are rich.
Well, I don't pay you money, sorry.
You said don't
pay already.
Okay. We need the Minister of Finance.
Yeah. I don't pay your money. Okay, the thing is, we talk about e-payment. Okay, on internet, on the internet, online, shopping, everything, okay, even your daily, routines, okay, a lot of people still using cash. Okay, but in the society, they try to move away from this cash. Okay, that's why they implement e-payment. Very early, we actually, Singapore government have developed, you all know, right? Okay, back in 1984.
Gyro.
Okay, there's this thing called gyro. Gyro is the one of the way to actually introduce e-payment, right? So that all your bill, okay, your telephone bill, your electricity, everything, no longer need to use check. Okay, no need to write check, no need to use cash to pay, no need to queue up to pay, right? You go through gyro, everything one shot, deduct from your bank account. Okay, as long as you maintain your cash, figure in your bank, you will deduct from there. So it's very convenient. Okay, but Singapore have not moved on after this gyro. Okay, a lot of people still using cash and check. Okay, so next comes in. Okay, so you can have ATM cards. This is like what is that machine? ATX machine. Okay.
AXX.
AXX machine. Okay, AXX machine, you just pay. Okay? No need gyro, but you pay through your convenience, right? Then, with the introductions of this ERP, okay, that's why they come out this net cash card, okay, so that you can pay cash. Okay, then our transport system to standardize, no need to count coins, because they find that counting coins is a chore. Okay, and printing all this coin also quite costly.
So, machine to count.
Huh?
Machine to count.
Machine to count.
Still need to count.
Still need to count.
Machine to count.
Now you will go to bank and bank in coin, you think, no?
What?
You will lose, no?
Yeah.
You will get a loss because they charge you for administration fee.
The machine the same.
Huh?
Same, after a certain amount, they charge.
Yeah, same. They will charge you. Okay? So that's why they come out this EZ-Link card. Okay? Then the next have come out more merchants, okay, to accept this fresh pay. Okay, even before the your Visa PayWay, right? Okay, this one net fresh pay is come out earlier. So more and more systems are coming online. Okay, like the fast Okay, this one is meant for transfer, account transfer. Okay, let's say you transfer from your bank account to somebody bank account. Okay, using fast. And then now they have introduced PayNow. PayNow even better. Okay? You can pay through a person phone number, handphone number or IC number. You all know that if you register PayNow with your IC number, what benefit do you have? Huh?
Money credit. Some credit.
Okay. The government want to give you money, will be very fast. Okay? Whatever ang pao the government will give you, if your PayNow is registered using your IC number, you will receive earlier. Okay? Because it will save them postage cost.
What's the amount?
Huh?
How much credit?
How much
they give you the money?
$100. Depends on what kind of ang pao they give you lah. The last year they give you 100 or 300 lah. So it depends lah. Not every time they give, right? Okay, another thing is for those age above 55. Okay, let's say you want to cash out your CPF. If your PayNow is registered under your IC number, okay? You just fill out an online form in the CPF board, okay? Straight away the money will credit to your PayNow, your bank account, very fast. Okay, almost instant. It takes about a few hours. Okay, so this is a very easier way to get money. Okay, if you have money inside CPF.
How do you register with the IC number?
Oh, if your PayNow, right? Under PayNow, your bank
link.
Your link, okay, they ask you to register under, usually it's phone number, okay? Then you say you want to opt to register under your IC number, then you...
All banks using this.
Yes, all the banks using
it. The major
banks,
the five
banks. Okay, PayNow, PayNow only this bank, this bank, nine bank. Okay, this nine bank. Bank of China, Citibank, DBS, POSB, HSSB, HSBC, okay, then ICBC, Maybank, OCBC, Standard, UOB.
What about the transfer charges?
Huh?
Will you receive there is any charges?
PayNow, no.
Or when we receive, no need, they don't deduct any amount.
No,
only we
no
pay, we, the payer pay money, I mean cost only, right?
No lah, nobody.
No, zero.
Don't tell me, please.
No, nothing.
This is PayNow.
PayNow. This is PayNow.
You can do only one bank.
Yeah, one bank.
One. You can't link.
You link to one bank. Your main account.
But overseas payment, they cannot use this.
No. When you overseas, you pay to those in the PayNow pay.
Singapore dollar.
No, let's say you go to Philippines. Can I transfer any of this to PayNow?
They don't have PayNow. If the guy in Philippines have an account in the Singapore bank, one of this nine bank, then you can transfer to him, then you can collect that. Okay? So this thing, not only having your mobile number, your NRIC, but also there's a another number for company.
NIC is for local, PIN number is for foreigner.
Is it? Yeah. PIN number
you
for
use a phone to pay, is it?
No,
PayNow, how
do you have a token? What is that for? If you have token, how does it
work? Token is locked into your account.
Is it in your phone?
Why?
The PayNow.
Why?
You want to send money to PayNow?
No, it's through the phone.
When your phone account number is checked. Okay,
later we'll go through all this later. Okay? Okay, then now they actually having this pay now for corporate. Okay? Like SMS,
pay you $1 back.
Like SMS, we actually having this number. You know, right? SMS have this UEN number.
Membership fees. Is it?
Let's say you want to pay SF membership fee, SMS, okay, pay SMS membership fee using the UEN.
Do you have the figures how many have already gone into this pay now?
Who?
How many Singaporeans have already gone into this pay now?
You would tell.
I don't know.
Some government just coming for the right.
Okay, the okay. There are many actually the unified point of sales. One of the main thing is this one. It's called Singapore Quick Response Code, the QR code. Because they found that many of these mobile apps, okay, the mobile payment apps, okay, was implemented, okay, and each of them having their own unique QR code. So those merchants, like the hawker center, some hawker, okay, they subscribe to maybe 3 or 4 e-wallet, okay, then they got a lot of QR code for you to scan, so you don't know which to scan, and people will make mistakes. The more you give them, the more mistakes they make. That's why they come up one standardized, okay, called the SGQR. So with this SGQR, it will be the one code for all the merchants streamline. Okay, so for this, it will be will be much easier for the user, not so confused. Okay, it's easy for the user to use.
So the user use what? The user use what?
It can be used anything, like PayLah, GrabPay. You can use GrabPay, you can use PayLah, or something else. Dash. Okay? So as long as your e-wallet, you got money inside, you tap, okay, the money will transfer to them, and they happy, you happy. No need to cash.
Power, no power, then
cash.
So for this SGQR, it's something like e-wallet. You have to
transfer. No. It's
or is it
just
directly into a bank account?
It's just, SGQR is it's just a code only. SGQR is just a code only.
Then how do you transfer your fund from your bank to the bank? How do you transfer your fund? Let's say on the pay. $5.
Yeah, SGQR is just like that only.
Okay. Then if I scan this, how do the system know that it go to my bank account and deduct $5 and pay to the particular stuff?
Those merchants, they will actually this once you scan this, okay, it will go to a unique number. And this unique number will identify who this guy is.
Who is this merchant?
So you
link to
their
account.
Whoever the merchant having their account will link to their account.
Then you got to deduct your payment from your bank, right? To your, so that means this.
No, not bank. It depends on what kind of apps that you use. Okay? Like PayLah is not a bank. PayLah is a wallet.
Wallet.
E-wallet. So you must put in money inside this PayLah. Then you just deduct from there.
So besides SG QR, you still have another e-wallet somewhere?
Yes.
Oh, that's how you deal.
So confused eh? Very confused eh?
Very confused.
I thought it's just a code only.
This is like a e-wallet itself.
No, this is a code only. This is only single number. Saying that everybody using one number to identify.
So PayNow is also a wallet, is it? PayNow.
Huh?
PayNow is a wallet.
PayNow is not a wallet.
PayNow is what?
Huh?
PayNow is a wallet, then what is it?
PayNow is not a wallet. PayNow is linked to your bank account.
Directly to your bank account.
It's linked to your bank account, it's not a wallet. Okay, you see when we talk about e-payment, okay, they have a few type of e-payment, okay? The thing is, there are a few type of e-payment, okay? E-payment, they have implemented a wallet form, meaning that it's just a wallet. So you register with this company, have this wallet, and you park money inside this wallet, and you use it. Okay? Of course, you can link this wallet to your and bank account or your credit card account, okay? But it's still a wallet. So the top up will be based on your setting. Okay, let's say if this thing left with $5, you want to top up from your bank another $100, you can set. Okay, but it's still a wallet. So every time you will maintain that amount, set amount. So you use it to pay for any small spending. Let's say hawker center or whatever.
Okay, then PayNow. PayNow is a wallet, then now.
What?
Pay, I understand.
PayNow, okay, then this is actually wallet, e-wallet. Okay. And then there's another one called PayNow is one of them is linked to a bank account. Okay? It's linked to a bank account. Just like this PayPal. PayPal. Okay? PayNow, okay, all these are linked. They are linked to bank account or linked to credit card account. Once you link, okay, whatever you pay, straight away will deduct from your bank account or deduct from your credit card account.
So wallet is safer lah, because you can cap the amount in your wallet lah, that they can take lah.
It's safe.
It's
safe.
It's
the.
You automatic top up
one.
You can disable the automatic one. I use my pounds, then they take the Sing dollar and convert it into pounds.
Yeah, yeah.
So when you go to your bank account, no, it's inside here.
It's stored inside.
It's stored inside. So when you
YouTube.
So no need to convert into pounds. Just Sing dollars. Oh. Anything you buy in pounds, but you need to convert
it.
They convert on the spot.
On the spot. On the spot.
Exchange rate.
PayNow. Up to you to set. It's next to no limit. Okay, you can set 5,000, you can set 20,000, 50,000, up to you.
Good thing you lose your wallet, you can just stop it straight away.
Yes, of course. Okay, so the that is the e-wallet lah. Okay, e-wallet as well as some link. Okay. Account is to link with your bank account, link with your credit card account. Okay? Some is just like credit card. Okay? Some they just as a credit card, So you just charge. Once you charge, it will charge with your credit card. That's all. Okay? Just like the recently, right, I mean this TransLink. It's easy link, they came out what SimpliGo. SimpliGo is just, I mean, link with your credit card. So you just tap, okay, actually the money will get from your credit card. Okay? So it's very convenient for people who actually seldom use public transport. Okay? And you don't want to maintain an EasyLink card. Okay? It's because EasyLink card you need to top up some money inside. And this money actually got expiry date. Because the card has expiry date.
Yeah.
10 years. Okay? So you have to spend it. Okay? So with this SimpliGo, you just use a link with your credit card and then you just tap your credit card. Yes. Okay, the thing is SimpliGo is tagged with this thing called NFC. Okay, we have this thing called NFC. Near field communication. Okay? Near field communication is a device. Alright? It can be exist in your card or in the phone itself. Okay, some phone will come with NFC. But of course those are not the $54 phone. Okay?
I also don't have iPhone also.
Huh?
iPhone.
iPhone have?
Don't have.
NFC, near field communication. So with this, once you have this, and then you can use it to for all these mobile payment. Okay, with near field.
Near field is it Wi-Fi? Is it?
Huh?
Near field is it Wi-Fi? Is it?
No, it's Wi-Fi.
No Wi-Fi.
Near field is no Wi-Fi. Near field is actually operate on usually a particular frequency, 13 point something meg, but 13.5 meg. 13.56 meg. So they have this thing. You have to close, normally very close. Okay, it's 10, only about 10mm or 20mm on near field. That's why it's called near. Okay? Supposedly it was safe, but hackers do have a device to actually detect this near field. So everything, there's a risk. Okay, so that's why they have all this cap, okay, built in onto all this card. They say that the card can only store like your EasyLink card is $500. Okay, maximum $500 for EasyLink. Okay, some card is $2,000, some card $1,000. So it depends on the systems itself. They try to limit, the amount so that if you lost, you will lost only this amount. Okay, you will not lose everything. Okay? But for those that is linked to your credit card, linked to your bank account, then you must report immediately if you lost. Okay? Once you report immediately, they will stop all the transaction, and that's it.
The best is you trick wallet. Yeah. When you lose it, you just phone, you just press a few buttons, it's locked. So that's about the best.
Yeah. Definitely, the thing is
Okay,
you should talk about some of the things that actually they implement. Okay, like PayNow, okay, was actually like an e-wallet. Okay, but this e-wallet is linked to your bank account. So a lot of time you can use this fast will actually do the bank transfer. Okay, let's say you need to transfer a lot of money to somebody, you can use fast. Okay, the merchant also, like your insurance or your credit card bill, you can actually pay through fast. Okay, they have account. Okay, so there is they call it. Yes.
Do you have multiple accounts? So your fast, you have PayNow, and your multiple accounts.
No. One is the same app. Okay, but when you transfer, you're using different portions of your function.
Do you think fast will be obsolete, replaced by PayLah?
I'm not sure. I don't know why they implement so many things. But it's actually backend. The one is actually backend. For the user, I don't care. They can pay, then pay. I don't care whether it's fast or using PayNow or whatever.
Excuse me.
Yes.
For Chinese system, they only have one.
No.
They still have many.
There are many.
Many like this.
The very two famous one is Alipay and this WeChat. The two famous ones. Alipay, they call it 支付宝 Alipay. Then the other is WeChat.
Because I remember reading in Malaysia, they want the WeChat system. So for them, maybe they only have one.
Not sure, it depends on how they want to implement. But maybe with Najib out of the picture, then different story.
We cannot check. You cannot check
anymore. No, Najib a lot of dealing with China.
Yeah.
But now.
Now he's no more there, so we cannot check anymore.
Don't know.
So among all these things, which one has the highest fraud cases? And you never heard of fraud cases.
So far, none reported.
If my phone has all this pain now, even when I drop,
yeah.
I think I lost my phone for 5 hours. I forgot because I don't know. So
but no,
five
but
hours,
the thing
nothing
is,
can happen, right?
Yeah, but the thing is, you see, the thing is, PayNow is not by the phone alone. Okay, usually PayNow is through biometrics, either your eye or your fingerprint.
Another check.
Yeah, or if you log in through the token. So the guy only have your phone, doesn't have any other thing.
Well,
so it will be a bit difficult to get a second set. Yes.
There's any technical discrepancy, say I pay and then he never received. So what happened?
The thing is whenever you pay, okay, so we SMS will send to you.
You have the SMS, but he said he never received. You want to claim from you again, so what happened?
Don't pay. That's
not a problem anymore.
That's not a payment problem.
It can happen.
I think that one no problem. Because the other person, in his account, it is stated that he got money. He cannot argue, you know.
Cannot argue.
Because if you say the other side say never pay, the bank will check. And then the bank say it has been paid into the other person's account. So he lose.
Unless you give the wrong number, maybe wrong phone number to somewhere there.
Yeah, very safe.
But normally you put a phone number, the name of the guy, the person, the phone will came out also.
Now by the time you get all the evidence, it's already too late. That means you pay double, two times already.
No, when the bank has responded for you,
well, this one is human body, argue like hell. You go to coffee shop, same thing. You pay, the fella come, they say you didn't pay.
The one you pay, you had a record. Yeah. Any problem is the bank and what are there, but it's not your problem anymore.
Is it the bank record show the account, that's it.
Okay, this was actually a report on 2016, 2016. You see the amount of cash transaction in the whole of the consumer transaction, okay? 2.2 million transaction.
Wow. Transactions, not the amount.
Not amount, it's a transaction.
This is the day or a month.
Huh?
This is the day or a month.
They never say anything, but I believe 2.something million transaction.
One day lah.
One year. 2015.
Huh? One year.
A year,
2015.
A year.
2015.
Yeah. 1 whole year.
Cannot be. There is one person in transact one time.
Cannot
be.
Billion. Okay. So in 2015, okay, you can see that 60% still using cash. Okay? And only 14% use credit card. 13% debit card. Okay? 12% fund transfer and 1% still using check. Actually, government want to stop the check.
No more check.
They want to stop the whole check issue. Ask you to do transfer, fund transfer. Okay, for business, you see, a lot of them using fund transfer. Okay? Check only 30%. Cash 14%. So you can see that actually business using cash have not as many, as lower.
More risk.
Yeah. Because business they want evidence. They have evidence, that's why if you use a bank transfer or check, you got the evidence.
And the check stops.
Yeah. Okay, so this was some reports on Singapore. If you look at this, this is actually the consumer payment itself. The yellow one is actually all the cash. See, wet market or hawker center, more than 80% still using cash. It's very convenient. Okay? The credit card, not as many. Okay? Credit card or debit card, then check, have people use check, no?
Supplier.
Okay, next. Okay, the rest is next. This one is next. I mean the credit card next. Okay, some check, no? And but majority cash. Okay, small shop or neighborhood shop. Okay, more next, really.
Is it?
Yeah, more next one, I see. the next compared to hawker center, this next got more. Okay, but of course, majority still cash. Okay. They give parent allowance now more on the transfer. Some paycheck, some transfer, but a lot of they give cash. Okay, domestic salary, cash also. So you see a lot of things are all, majority are all using cash. Singapore is still
cash is
key. Still rely on a lot of cash. Okay, so they want to do away, try to move, shift all these things. Okay, just like China.
Because they are communist country, they can government to remove the same one. Communist country government said yes, yes.
Yeah, correct.
That's the reason.
That's why they can move very fast.
No, yeah, because they no argument.
You put MRT, you touch the
EDP, you want to build a road, you argue for 25 years. The road still not built.
Like India, cannot because they are. They talk. China said, build.
No, you must understand the difference. India, the land are over 10 years.
Yeah.
The landlords are, all the rich people are the landlords. Yes. That's China government is the landlord.
They said, build. So, next year you see, they understand.
Overseas transaction, mostly credit cards.
Yes. See, overseas, online, all credit card. Not many people using cash.
When we go to China, what's the problem we face?
People can take your wallet easily, the e-wallet. They said that because you are ready to pay, they can just hijack your payment.
Yeah, they can just stop it from the phone.
Unless you open the China bank account. Or you buy the Alipay or second
Alipay. Your payment, then all this one.
Same color.
No, this color. Pure payment, this color.
Oh.
Then this color.
Slightly
darker. Okay. All the bill, all the credit card bill, all this got pure payments. Okay, but some more using cash. You see. More use cash. Okay. Credit card. Then the next.
Bitcoin not inside here.
Huh?
Bitcoin not inside here.
What people pay for Bitcoin? I don't know. This is what the MES, they do a survey, then they have this report and so on. Right? This company, this company called KPMG. Okay? So for this, that means they have study found that Singapore not that many people using the electronic payment. Okay, so PayNow is very simple actually. Okay. So you can use your mobile phone number or IC number. So you need to have a particular apps. Okay. Usually your bank apps are okay, like DBS is DBS Digital. Then they got OCBC, you got UOB, my Maybank, everything. Okay. So once you log in. Usually login is using your biometrics. Okay, it can be fingerprint or it can be through eyeball, your iris. Yeah. Then you enter the phone number or the IC number, the guy you want to pay, and then the amount. Then after you check through, you confirm you send. Okay? send, say okay, and straight away SMS will notify you saying the transaction has go through.
SMS.
Yeah, SMS.
Go through here.
The short messaging.
Short messaging. This is very important. Argue with you for one for months.
You say, I say. You say.
So for the PayNow login, your thumbprint
in
your phone, your thumbprint on your mobile is the
mobile. Normally, we don't use thumbprint.
Yeah.
See,
because thumb is too big.
No, but it's how to monitor.
Huh? Normally, we do use thumbprint. Thumb is too big.
NRIC, right?
Okay, we use either index or center finger.
Fingerprint.
Because thumb is too big. Normally,
so you
just
register that way using a fingerprint.
Yeah. On your phone, you just with the phone fingerprint, fingerprint, then you can just register a fingerprint.
Is that a scan or?
It depends on the type of phone.
Yeah,
the type of phone. Okay, like Apple phone is on the front. Okay, there's the round one. It can be thumb, it can be whatever finger. Okay. But for my phone is mine is in the back.
Otherwise, you just enter NRIC or your mobile number, is it?
Huh?
If it's not using your fingerprint.
No. Lock in is it can be fingerprint. Okay, lock in actually depends on your apps. Okay, some apps can be name, login name, then plus your PIN. PIN. And then
password.
Password. Then after that, it will authenticate, okay, through your dongle or something. Okay, if you don't use fingerprint, but normally you don't use fingerprint, the PayNow will not be activated. Okay, so they want biometrics.
By giving NRC number to other people,
or
they use NRC.
Somebody sleep.
No, it depends on who you're giving to NRC. Normally, it's government agency. These are normally for government agency. IC number. Not anybody.
Because nowadays, NRC people only give the phone the last four number. So now, you have to use all the full cell numbers or last four numbers. If you use the service.
NRIC. NRIC is a full number.
Doesn't feel secure. So know your IC number.
You send to
they
the
can
person,
find a lot of things.
The name.
Enter mobile or
the
number?
That means from your mobile
send
to that person's mobile.
So you pay the person mobile number. Then the number can go to one account.
Do they have pay now?
There's only one way to get
no, if they have PayLah, also can do.
Morning, uncle. Thank you.
Hey, hello. There you go. All right, uncle. Bye.
Hi, uncle.
Hi.
Good, uncle. You're so high tech.
Oh, yeah. It's much easier than cash payment. $5.80, please. PayNow?
PayNow. Thank you. Bye.
Bye. Hey, bro. How you do that?
It's easy. I just link my UAN to my bank account. And the bank created this QR code. Then I won't even need to queue because my cash taking.
That's right.
Wow.
Now? Wow, everyone's using it. It's making it so much easier, especially for bookkeeping. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
This is so convenient.
Yeah. Can you help with this?
So convenient.
Ah. Oh. PayNow.
The background.
So what is the registration goes up?
Huh? What information are you going to
see? Yeah. Hello? Let me go get my wallet. Can I pay by internet banking or check?
Don't worry.
You can pay now to me.
I'll make my mobile number to my bank account.
You use PayNow as well? I use PayNow. I have a mobile number. It's so easy.
You can send a receipt money using your mobile number.
Phone number.
Excuse me, I don't have PayNow.
So you buy a
bank. PayLah, PayLah.
Otherwise,
you
have
PayNow.
Have to. Otherwise, we cannot make business.
We have several banks. Which bank should we link with PayNow?
Up to choose.
Only one. No, we got 3 banks.
Here's how. Log into your bank's mobile banking app. Scan the QR code using your bank's app. If the amount isn't generated, just enter the amount to pay. Confirm the payment and it's done. Use QR codes to make payments to the payments. For purchases, bills, online shopping, and more, just look for the PayNow logo.
How to receive money?
When you go to my account,
with PayNow, you can receive money securely using a mobile number. Here's how easy it is to get started. Log into your internet banking or mobile banking. Link your mobile number and receive it to your bank account and key in the display name for PayNow. Done! Now you can receive money using your mobile number. PayNow is offered by these participating banks. Find out more at pbs.org.sg/paynow or ask your bank for more details.
No need to eat out.
Now you can receive money using your mobile number. PayNow is offered by these participating banks. Find out more at abs.org.sg/PayNow or ask your bank for more details. How to send money?
You have to choose UEM.
UEM, yes.
Because I touch here, you can't see which screen. It's the second row.
Second row.
Type.
And under UEN, you enter the UEN number. It's S79SS0023BB. I remember because I keep on typing.
This one is okay.
Then the amount you have to pay your fee, 110. Then the remarks, you put your name. Okay, unless you are very famous, you can put like that. Then people know who you are. I say I know Ken already. Because I will receive.
TSV or CBS?
Sky. Okay, then done. And then this is a very funny thing with Maybank. The button, the submit button is at the bottom, you must scroll up. No, stupid. I told them, they asked me to catch screenshot, show them. Oh, waste my time. And then after you press next,
the debit from
is
the
baby account.
Oh,
you go through already,
not registered.
$1 you can
put that. Oh, you say not registered. 79SS0023B, wrong.
Oh, wrong.
So you must see, there's a name there. And the nickname, my nickname not registered. This person, this account don't have PayNow. So, not registered, other you see Singapore Micro Computer Society. So they make another transfer, Okay, okay, the thing is, for me, because I will make payment already, I just type new payee. I can see already, Micro Computer Society, okay. So it's there, yeah. You know? Then I put the amount, okay.
This debit prompt is from whose account?
Huh?
Your own account, is
it,
or
somebody's? My account lah. Otherwise, I police cash if I go into somebody's
account. $110.
$110. You want cent, you put that $0.00 cent or $0.00 cent. Then you put your nickname lah. Tan Boon Sua. Okay. Then done. But haven't finished. You see the bottom button, this button and button. You must please place. This is only peculiar for Maybank.
Scan,
then the name will come out.
Scan there at the next.
So that day I thought this one is done already. Actually it's not done yet. There's a button at the bottom. So that day I collect money from Patrick, I said done already. He also see okay, he happy. Then I went back, I said, why? Oh, I transfer all my inside. I want to go Maybank and scroll them already. Then I realized actually there's a button below. I forgot about this button. So you don't confirm, then nothing happens.